The Metropolitan Opera presents... Our guest this afternoon is the brilliant Metropolitan Dramatic Soprano, Marjorie Lawrence. With us, too, are the General Manager of the Metropolitan Opera Association, Mr. Edward Johnson, the noted conductor, Wilfred Pelletier, in the orchestra, as well as the young American tenor, A.E. Wilder, Jr., discovered in preliminary audition. And here is your genial host, Edward Johnson.
Thank you, Mr. Cross. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. We welcome you to another Metropolitan Informal, as it were, during which you will be brought closer to the human side of the Metropolitan and its personalities. An epitaph in Westminster Abbey reads, "Here lies Henry Purcell, Esquire, who left this life and is gone to that blessed place where only his harmony can be exceeded." The Henry Purcell in question was the father of English opera, who in 1680 wrote the beautiful Dido and Aeneas. One of its masterly as well as moving arias is "When I Am Laid in Earth," otherwise known as Dido's Lament. We'll hear it sung now by Marjorie Lawrence. Miss Lawrence.
Thank you.
Marjorie Lawrence is a famous soprano, but she is also a famous soldier. Not one who fights with the usual weapons of war, but a soldier just the same. She has proved it in her own case, on the long road back from a grave affliction. And she has proved it again in a recent tour of her native land, Australia, where she sang for thousands of servicemen of four allied nations, Australia, United States, Great Britain, and the Netherlands.
Yes, Mr. Johnson, she traveled 50,000 miles on that tour of hers. One afternoon in a little tent hospital in Australia.
So good of you to visit us, Miss Lawrence. As you can see, these boys were not able to come to your performance, and they're so eager to meet you.
Oh, but I wanted to come. Are there many here?
Quite a few. Terribly brave chaps. Here, Sergeant, will you please help me? Easy now. Let's take Miss Lawrence over there, near Herbert.
Who is Herbert?
A very likable young Scotchman. Herbert Martin. Shrapnel. Leg. There. Thank you, Sergeant. Is this all right, Miss Lawrence?
Fine. Fine. Hello, Herbert. Nice to see you.
Hello, Miss Lawrence. Nice to see you. Glad you came.
So am I. You from Scotland?
Yes'm. Aberdeen.
Well, that's fine. A very famous opera soprano was born there, too. Mary Garden. Do you know her?
No, ma'am. Never met her. But I know who she is. We have some of her gramophone records back home.
Do you like music?
Oh, lots. All kinds.
Not a musician, are you?
Oh, just a music lover. Wish I'd taken it up, though.
What did you do back there in Scotland?
Oh, nothing much. I was going to college. Thought I might go into business. My father's business. I got to give that up. Won't be able to get around, so we'll know.
Oh, you'll get around, all right. There are ways, you know.
Aye, I guess so. Doctor told me that. But I thought I might turn to writing. Sort of like to put thoughts down on paper.
That's the spirit. What kind of writing do you prefer?
Oh, stories of adventure. You know, sports. I used to be quite an athlete, and I always had a yearning to travel. Do you do much traveling, Miss Lawrence?
Well, I've done a lot of it in peacetime, and I'm supposed to do quite a lot of it now. 50,000 miles in a wheelchair, going some, isn't it?
Miss Lawrence, I think you're a great sport, and your being here has taught me a lot. Miss Lawrence, will you sing a song for me?
I'd be delighted to. That is, if I know it.
Oh, you know it. I heard you sing it on the radio when you were in England last. It is Loch Lomond.
Loch Lomond. Why, that's practically my favorite song. And I'm so glad it's yours, too. Of course I'll sing it. Raymond, how about doing Loch Lomond?
Banks and the yon bonny braes, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and my true love have ever run to thee. On the bonny, bonny banks on Loch Lomond, I'll take the high road, and I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland afore. Scotland afore ye, but me and my true
Well, Miss Lawrence, who wouldn't go 50,000 miles to hear that? Did you have to confine yourself to a limited number of songs when you were in Australia?
No, Mr. Johnson. Those boys want good music. And what's more, they know good music. That young Scotchman, Herbert Martin, started something that day. When I got finished, all the others in the hospital made requests. And by the time the little recital was over, I had done a pretty representative survey of worthwhile music. And it was the same all over.
And what did they especially like in opera?
Well, for some reason, Il est doux, il est bon, from Massenet's Herodiade, had many admirers.
Well, I'm sure there are many admirers of that aria listening in right now. So for them, won't you please sing Il est doux, il est bon?
With pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'll be happy to know that Miss Lawrence will sing for us again in a few minutes. And now we come to a moment that may prove to be a significant one for an aspiring young artist. which you now hear announces for the 10th consecutive year and the 211th time that opportunity knocks for a young American singer. And this week's aspirant is A.E. Wilder, Jr., a young tenor from Hammond, Louisiana. Mr. Wilder received his musical education at Louisiana State University, and he has had some experience in amateur operatics. For several years, he has been teaching voice at Southeastern Louisiana College, where he is also conductor of the choral ensemble. And so, a candidate for a Metropolitan Opera contract, A.E. Wilder, Jr., now sings Salut Demeure, Sauf Secure, from Gounod's Faust. Mr. Wilder. Thank you. Norwegian composer, Edvard Grieg, has written music that is foolproof. By that I mean it stands up well, no matter to what style it is converted. The score of the Broadway operetta Song of Norway shows clearly how it can take the American popular type of treatment. All that, of course, is because the melodies are appealing and as fresh as the day that they were created. And we now hear Marjorie Lawrence sing a special favorite of the concert audiences. Grieg, I Love Thee.
Thank you. tressaillir. J'ai fait passer les yeux d'un feu, mais moi, entre d'un dieu sévère, oui, je le dois, oui, je le dois.
Metropolitan Opera Presents, starring Marjorie Lawrence, has come to you through the facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service.